I think like the mark of a good storyteller is being able to take the mundane and make it interesting rather than doing something that's so extreme, therefore you're going to get views.
This is Spotlight, an interview series where we dive into people's creative spaces, ask them questions about their creative processes and career in hopes of educating and inspiring you to create more. Today, we're with Jack Cook, director and content creator based in Los Angeles, best known for his daily vlog.
Daily vlog number one.
Which has been consistent for the past 692 days. We spent the day with him vlogging across New York City and speaking at the TikTok headquarters. Jack has been able to monetize his daily vlog and make his passion for telling stories a full-time living. From partnering with brands like Heineken, Amazon, and Guayaki, to building a loyal following of over 100,000, Jack is really the king of consistency. Without further ado, let's get into this episode.
Hi, how's it going? The Bev is like my coffee. I don't go a day without it. Anywhere in the world that I am, I'm going to find the Bev. Today we have mint. It's always my go-to. Literally can't go a day without it.
I feel like so many people, and this is such a big stigma of social media right now, is I did this 30 days in a row, and so many people are like, I'm gonna work out every day, I'm gonna read 10 pages of a book a day, but it's so hard for people to actually follow through on that. Why do you feel like you've been able to actually consistently do this? Because you're at vlog, what, 600? 90?
688.
688. Today. So 688 straight days of doing something.
Yeah. From the beginning, it was creating from a place of this is going to be a creative outlet for myself. And the ability to be consistent with it didn't even really come from being dedicated to it or being hardworking. A lot of times those things will get tested very easily. And if you don't actually love what you're doing, you're going to fold under the pressure of those kind of situations. So really and truly, the only reason I've been able to do it for this long, this consistently, never missing a day, is because I'm actually obsessed with it. Like, today is day 688 and I'm walking around New York City being like, what new clip can I get to like better visually tell this 1 minute vlog? It's a great texture right here. Walking sign, street sign, sun, trees. I mean, that's perfect.
She loved it too.
Yeah, she loved
it. And like, if I didn't love the process of making them, that would never be my thought. And I would only be thinking of how can I make this bigger and how can I get more views? And that's gonna lead to burnout really quickly.
There's a little bit of me that's visually like, oh, this is like a texture of something that like kind of puts you in the scene. Like, we're in New York, so I'm trying to look for stuff that makes you feel like you would be in New York if you're watching the video. So like skyscrapers, the walk sign right there with the street lights, that kind of stuff like feels like New York and feels like the New York energy. So it's kind of like what I'm looking for.
Life isn't always exciting. Life isn't always like, oh my God, I gotta get this on camera.
Totally.
So like, how are you going out into the world and finding those new moments and finding those pieces of inspiration on a mundane day?
Those outcomes of like the views and the followers and the numbers and stuff, like I can't control the outcomes. I can only control my inputs every day. And so I think about every day, what are the things that I can control? What are the inputs that I can make today to make today's video better than yesterday's? I think like the mark of a good storyteller is being able to take the mundane and make it interesting rather than doing something that's so extreme, therefore you're going to get views.
All right, we're getting close, right? Going to public speak, like talking about making daily TikTok vlogs, absolutely not. Did not think that I would ever get to call this a job.
I'm just curious to know, like, what do you regard as your most successful brand partnership to date? And, you know, what was kind of special about it?
Yeah, for me, I worked with Heineken recently at the Formula One race in Miami.
Come with us to Miami for the F1 GP.
I think that it went great because, you know, I'm doing my daily vlog, so basically I'm showing all of the things that happen throughout my day.
As well as plenty of celebrities. The Jonas Brothers, the Williams sisters, and Tom Cruise. All right, let's get back to the racing.
And so they said, hey, come to this experience. You're here for 4 days. The only thing that you have to do is make your vlog. We like the way that you make your thing. Put Heineken in it, of course. We want you to, like, you know, show the product. They put me in, like, the Heineken suite, so there's a lot of branding there visually for them. But there was nothing else other than make your vlog, do your thing. And I think, like, the videos then played really well with the audience. Like, it felt very organic.
It feels like forever since we've had an F1 race weekend. This one was quite entertaining.
I didn't feel like there were certain, like, things that I had to say. It was just like a very organic partnership because I was already doing the vlog and it just made sense me being there.
What would you say are some, like, do's and don'ts of working with brands, being a creator?
The do's are stay true to yourself. Make sure you know what your value is. And when a brand tries to tell you that you have to do certain things, you have to be willing to have some tough conversations and push back on them and say, I'm willing to do it this way. Like, let's come to a happy medium. You have to work with the brand a little bit. You have to achieve the goal that they're trying to achieve. But you, in the same sense, don't want the brand to control the type of content that you're making. Otherwise, the video ends up being inauthentic. Your audience is gonna think, you know, you're just selling out for the brand, whatever it is, and that's not what you want either.
I think they were excited from it.
So, I mean, you're doing a lot. Like, you're making a vlog every day, you're doing these brand videos. Do you ever feel like you just get burnt out? You're not motivated anymore, you're too tired, or do you ever find those moments of, like, fuck, I'm human. Maybe I can't do this all the time.
Luckily, right now, you know, there are times when things are really busy, and I'm like, oh, my mind's a little bit stretched. But I have the foresight to know that eventually that's gonna calm down. You can get in the mindset of trying to fight wherever the tide is taking you. So when things are busy, you want things to be less busy. And when things aren't busy, you want things to be more busy.
Always.
Yeah. But I'm also at a place in my life right now where I'm 25 years old, I'm getting to do what I love every day, and I'm getting to work with some pretty incredible brands. So the fact that this gets to be my job is very exciting for me, and I don't wanna take any moment of it for granted.
Yeah.
A lot of times I am fighting with myself, and a lot of times I am good with it, and a lot of times I'm, you know, having that conversation with my girlfriend Mallory, being like, I really need things to pick up right now, and she's like, you just have to be patient, and I'm like, I'm so overwhelmed right now, and she's like, you just have to, you know, work day to day and get through it, like, you're gonna work hard, you're gonna be okay, you know, so it's just a balance, and, like, you're always gonna have those conversations internally with yourself.
I mean, I guess on the subject of thinking about right now, thinking about the future, like, what's next for Jack? Like, what are you looking at? What are you looking forward to?
Yeah, I've been thinking of the vlog a little bit more broadly recently and been like, how can I turn the content I'm making and the vlog in general into something that feels like somebody's favorite TV show almost? How can I have characters that people are attached to, storylines that people want to follow and see the end of? And so that's sort of my end goal in mind with the vlog and content is like, can I be producing things so that when someone says, hey, what's your favorite TV show right now? Someone's immediate reaction is like, Jack Cook's vlog.
We're about to start. Let's go find our table.
Something to stick into. There's character development. Yeah. You know, there's storylines.
They're like, he's at this place now. He's trying to go here. I want to see him achieve that. Or, like, you know, whatever it is. For me, create more means creating things for yourself.
Product pictures for the shirts. So we're gonna try and set up.
I think as a creative, a lot of times I had this experience where I get stretched making things for other people, and the ability to create more sometimes can be creating for yourself.
All right, so this is what we made. We made it out
like
of
the personal passion projects, I think, as an artist or a creative is like the thing that fires you up the most. And having the ability to create more things to create for yourself is really important. It gives you, like, the fire to keep creating, because if you're only doing things that are sort of draining you, you might lose that passion. But if you create something that's for yourself, you're able to then continue to create and create more as a result.
We always get such gems, dude. I'd never know what people are gonna say, and I love it. I love it. Cool. Thanks so much. That's a wrap.